I have to explain here left linear grammar and right linear grammar. A grammar G equal to VTSP. VTSP have their usual meaning. Is said to be left linear if it is of the form A. A is the non-terminal which is producing another non-terminal gear X. X is a terminal or some X which is terminal. It is not necessary if it is A here, it should be A. Okay? It may be any symbol from terminals or any group of terminals. But here, there will be only single non-terminal in leftmost side. Okay? So this will be left linear grammar, and it is said to be right linear grammar if it is of the form A produces X capital B, which is non-terminal or X, where AB belongs to V. V is the set of non-terminals and X belongs to terminal closure. So including it may be lambda or any terminal symbol. Okay, I will take an example here. If S is the start symbol which is producing AA and A is producing BA or lambda, this is right linear grammar because here S and A are the non-terminals and here A, which is the non-terminal, is at the rightmost side. A is producing BA, which is at the rightmost side, or lambda. Okay? So, this is right linear grammar. Okay, if it is, one more grammar is there which is producing BA or yes BA and B is producing AB. Okay, so this is left linear grammar. This is left linear grammar because here one non-terminal is there and which is at the leftmost side. Here all terminals are there. So this will be left linear grammar. And right linear grammar, if the grammar is either right linear or left linear, will be regular. So it will be regular. It will also be regular. If there is one more grammar, if I take example 1, example 2, if there is one more grammar in example 3, S is producing AA, A is producing BB and B is producing CD and C is producing some E. So I can see here in this production it is right linear. In this production it is right linear because non-terminal is at rightmost side, non-terminal is at rightmost side. Here non-terminal is at leftmost side. So this is left linear. Okay, so this grammar as a whole will be neither left linear nor right linear. It means it will be combination of left and right, but not regular. So this is not regular grammar. In this grammar, some productions are of the form this BX and some are of the form XB. It means this is the combination of left linear grammar and right linear grammar. Therefore, it will not be regular grammar. This is a right linear grammar. Okay, what language will it generate? A, then A is producing A, then B. If I construct its finite automata, S is the start state, then taking symbol A, it is reaching in other state A, okay, and from A, taking A, it is in A, and taking B, it is reaching in some final state. If this final state is B, it is reaching in B. Okay, so this is a finite automata. If I construct its regular expression, it will be A star B. Okay, now if I just change this production as S produces AA and A produces AA or B. What language shall I get from this production? Here the string is ending with B. Here what will happen? The string will start with B. So the regular expression for this left linear grammar will be B A, there will be at least one A or maybe more A's, more than one A's, one A or more than one A. Okay, so it will be of this form. So I can see here I am getting A star B, here I am getting B A star. I can write it is same as A plus, means at least one occurrence of A and B, and here it is same as B A plus B, then occurrence of A at least one time. Okay, so this is the reverse, this is the reverse of this string or this regular expression. So whatever language will be produced by this left linear of this grammar will be the reverse of this language. Okay, the whatever language is generated by right linear grammar, if I reverse that grammar, it will generate reverse of that language. Okay, I will write here, if there is some finite automata which is generating language L and its corresponding right linear grammar will also generate language L, then if how can I generate this grammar? If I reverse this finite automata, what will happen? This B will be the initial state. This is the final state, which will be the initial state now. Okay, now the arrows will be changed and initial state will be the final state. So taking B from B, it will be reaching on state A, and from A to A, it will be in A, and taking A from A, it will be reaching in state S, which will be the final state now. Okay, so I can see here it is producing B at least one A, B A star concatenation with A, B A star concatenation with A. Okay, so it will be B A plus. Okay, now if I reverse the finite automata, it will be producing language LR. Okay, now if I take its right linear grammar of reverse finite automata, what it will be giving to me? It will be LR. I can see here, how can I write its right linear grammar? B produces BA, A produces AA or A. I can reach in the final state and nothing is required here. Okay, so this is the right linear grammar which is producing LR. Now if I take its if I reverse that right linear grammar, reverse or make the left linear grammar, then what will happen? B will be producing left linear grammar, B will be producing AB, and A will be producing AA or A. Okay, so it will be producing LLG. Okay, it will be producing language L. Now I can check here. The language will be ending with B, and there will be any number of A's here. Any number of A's means at least one A will be there. Okay, so it will be producing this language. Okay, now if there is some right linear grammar, I can convert left linear grammar for this right linear grammar which produces the same language with for this grammar. Okay, it means if this right linear grammar was producing language L, then I can write left linear grammar for this grammar which will produce the same language L.